Now taking their place in the sun, all the colors abound for the whole world around and for everyone under the sun. All the colors abound for the whole world around and for everyone under the sun. Okay, here's our Spanish verse. Let's all do our best to make a new color with the new language. De colores, de colores se visten los campos en la primavera. De colores, de colores son los pajaritos que vienen de afuera. De colores, de colores es el arco iris que vemos lucir, y por eso los grandes amores de muchos colores me gustan a mí. Y por eso los grandes amores de muchos colores me gustan a mí. Wow, everybody did great on the Spanish verse. That's fantastic. Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the spirit of love surround you everywhere.
Lisa, please stop recording.
This garden, all it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch and row by row, someone blessed these seeds I sow. Someone warmed them from below till the rains come tumbling down.
Do you want to lead us in the song? Find a stillness?
Yeah.
Didn't realize that was the entirety of the ceremony. Well, now I know. But great. Sure. Our next song is in the Grey Books. It's Find a Stillness. And it's a really neat song that I didn't know. Two verses. And let's try to sing it with the stillness that's in the lyrics. So maybe you'll just watch me and we'll take a little space in the songs. You'll need to have kind of half an eye down and half an eye up, but I think that we can make it work. I'll just play through once. It's quite short. Find a stillness. Let's sing it quietly. Find a stillness, hold a stillness, let the stillness carry me. Find the silence, hold the silence, let the silence carry me. In the Spirit, by the Spirit, with the Spirit's giving power, I will find true harmony.
Second verse, a cappella.
Seek the essence, hold the essence, let the essence carry me. Let the flower help me flower. Wash the flower, carry me. By the Spirit, with the Spirit's giving power, I will find true
Lovely.
That was a beautiful choice, Ted.
So it was all Megan's choice. So thank you, Megan.
And at the end of today's service, do please come up. Take flowers from the bouquet, take them home with you. By exchanging flowers, we show our willingness to walk together in our search for trust, disregarding all that might divide us. This communion of sharing is essential to a free people of a free religion. And now we're ready for our closing words. We're running a little ahead of it. Huh? Oh, where did that go? Offertory. You're right. Okay, now we pass our offertory basket. You're right. Oh, thank you, Buffy. All donations are gratefully welcomed. So if you make automatic pledge payments, please place one of those yellow cards in the basket to indicate this support. Thank you. Our closing words today were written by Elizabeth M. Strong. We have entered into the communion of flowers with joyful hearts. We have entered with reverent thoughts. It has taken long months between cold ground for these flowers to prepare their blooming. Excuse me, I'm having trouble with an eye. It has taken each of us long times of growth through sorrow and joy to prepare our living now. The blooming season is short. The flowers stay only a brief time. We are travelers upon the earth,
travelers through all too brief lifetimes. Therefore, let our moments be bountiful. Let us rejoice in our unique colors, aromas, and sounds. Let us celebrate together in love, that as we travel away, we take with us the memory of golden hours together among the flowers.
Thank you, Laura.
And now, please join me in reading the words provided for extinguishing our chalice. We believe it is here we must begin to seek the wisdom of children and the graceful way of flowers in the wind. For the children and the flowers are my sisters and my brothers. Their laughter and their loveliness could clear a cloudy day. Like music of the mountains and the colors of the rainbow, they're a promise of the future and a blessing for today. And the song that I am singing is a prayer to non-believers. Come and stand beside us. We can find a better way. Now is the time for announcements. Does anyone have any announcements? And I know a few people do.
Good morning, I'm Becky. And anybody that wondered where I was yesterday, this was sort of a joy and concern. The woman who was my matron of honor in another lifetime happened to have a commitment ceremony. My friend is 80, it's 80, her intended was 81, and we had a commitment ceremony yesterday, and so I was sort of her maiden waiting, so I was busy all day long with them, and that was such a joy. They are adorable. Okay, now my announcement, the falderal that's out in the social hall is due to my grandson, 7 years old, who has a rare fatal genetic disorder that has no treatment, no cure, and we are trying to raise money for research to find something that may make a difference in his life, and if not his, in children in the future. So it's called March Against Madness. So it starts on Tuesday when March Madness begins, and the finale is April 6th. I have extra flyers, so if anybody has any location around that has public bulletin board or schools or whatever that you know you want to take to share the information, I'm glad to give you them. And those, if they have a QR code that goes to the entire auction, you can go to it today and see the items as well as seeing the pictures out there. But you can't bid on them until Tuesday. Then also, if you don't do QR codes or know you want to give one to somebody who doesn't, I have one that has the web address as well. Those pictures will be displayed at Patron Saints Brewery in Toledo, because that's where we are going to do the finale on April 6th. The bidding will stop at 6 p.m. on April 6th, and anyone there can then take their item or their gift card or whatever home. So peruse, see if there's any interest, and feel free to share.
Quick question. If they want to bid on any of those items that are out on the table, can they scan the QR code for the item and bid?
Thank you. Okay. That there are individual QR codes on the individual items. So if you see something and you don't want to look through the whole auction, everything, you can just scan that item and it will take you exactly to that item description.
Online.
Starting Tuesday.
Oh, you can't do it till Tuesday.
Right. The auction begins March 19th.
Live. I had more questions. I've got a quick announcement. I am singing in a concert this afternoon, which we also performed last night in Rossford. It's a celebration of Schubert. And the concert was actually a lot better than I thought it was going to be. I thoroughly enjoyed singing in it. And part of it was because we had Christopher Scholl and his wife Ellen from BGSU, who are, I believe, on the voice faculty, who came and shared some Schubert with us. They sang duets and solos, and oh, they were wonderful. And then we did Schubert's Mass in G, our choir did, with a small chamber orchestra. Chamber orchestra was fabulous, and we weren't bad. So it's free, 3 o'clock today. at Perrysburg First Methodist Church on 2nd Street. I have flyers if you think you might be interested.
More announcements.
I'm Buffy, for anyone who is unaware of that.
Speak more loudly.
Okay. I didn't want to overpower anyone. I just wanted to let you know that in this week's letter that's going out, the email letter, there's going to be some information about a Palestine film festival that's currently taking place. Just to give you a heads up on a couple of them, it's being presented by the Media Decompression Collective, which has been very active even pre-disaster in Gaza. But just to let you know about a couple that are in the near future, they're nearby. On March 25th at 5:30 p.m. at the Woodland Mall, the Green Party is co-sponsoring one at 5:30, and also on April 6th at 1 p.m. at the Woodland Mall. And then on April 2nd at 5:30 at the Way Public Library, that one is a very impressive one that I saw that was presented by BGSU last week. If you want more information, look to the email or track me down and I can give you the information, and you can check out each individual showing what is being shown and where, just to let you know. Also, there will be a GoFundMe code that's available there. There is a BGSU student who is a doctoral student who is from Gaza, who has lost multiple dozens of family members, and house has been destroyed, and he's trying to get his family some medical attention, food and clothing to young siblings and nieces and nephews, and to get his parents out of there who are both in need of medical attention. So I have donated to the GoFundMe. I encourage you, even if it's $5, every little bit helps. And if you can't donate, if you could please pass it on electronically to people, email, TikTok, Instagram, anything you have available to let the word go out. Thank you.
And when you talk about the email newsletter, you mean the church email newsletter?
Yes.
It will be in the MVUUC news.
Yes. According to Megan, she has taken care of that and passed it on.
Okay.
Yeah. They're being shown in Toledo, Maumee, Perrysburg, and Bowling Green. Most of them are not repeats, so if you're interested in seeing multiple ones, you kind of have to track them down. Yesterday's was at the Frederick Douglass Center in downtown. So it's really important to kind of get a feeling and an understanding of where this started from and why it's continuing. And please call and write your congressmen and senators and let them know, hopefully, that you do not support genocide and that you'd like them to do something about stopping it.
Hi, I'm Dawn. Yesterday at the retreat, one of the things we talked about was helping out, even if you can assist in small ways. I work every other weekend, so I miss seeing you beautiful people. But I'm going to try to be the greeter when I'm here. I put out a handmade sign-up sheet for greeters right on the front greeter table. It's a half hour of your time on Sunday. And any of us who've been here a while can show you what tasks you need to do. So next week I'm working, and I'm working 3 weekends in April. So I would appreciate it if any of you would like to sign up from 10:30 to 11 to be a greeter and welcome our new people or visitors.
Thank you, Don, for taking on that responsibility. My name's Winnie Rex. I'm involved with a group that is sponsoring a Rock the Block event, also on April 6th. It sounds like there's a lot going on that day. But it is an event to clean up, help neighborhoods clean up their, neighbors clean up their yards. It might involve raking, doing a little painting, but some outdoor work like that. If you're interested, the flyer was in the newsletter this past week, and hopefully we'll be there again. So that's April 6th. It's from 9 to 2 o'clock, I think. So if you can volunteer a couple of hours of your time, we would appreciate it. Thank you.
All right.
So this coming Friday, the 22nd, the BGSU cello students, I'm the teacher, are presenting a concert at the Simpson Garden Park for the Brown Bag Recital Series. This is at 12:15. They're playing solo and ensemble pieces, and they've worked really hard. They're very talented. You'll also hear, I don't know if you've ever heard, a whole bunch of cellos playing at the same time, but it's pretty awesome. They're playing an arrangement of Bach's Brandenburg Concerto No. 6 and a medley of Abba tunes. So 12:15 Friday at the Simpson Garden Park at Conneaut and Winter Garden in the main hall there. Thanks. And thank you to Winnie for reminding me to make this announcement. I had forgotten about it myself.
Yes.
It's free, yes, indeed.
Lisa has a question.
That was my question.
Oh. Okay, yeah, it's free. Thanks.
Do you have something, Laura? Oh, okay. Any other announcements? Megan!
I'll make them really fast, I promise, because there's a lot of announcements. That's great. There's so much happening. And two things. Number one, if you haven't filled out our congregational survey yet, this goes out to members and friends, so visitors, don't worry about it. But if you're a member or a friend, you should have received an email from me with a link to the Google form, which is the survey. We also have a couple of printed out ones here. So I will be sending a reminder today to fill out that congregational survey. The second announcement is that our pledge campaign is going to start next Sunday. So get excited, get hyped, and look out for our pledge packet for this year in your email starting next Sunday. We will officially kick off next Sunday.
Yeah, and the pledge packet, you will be just amazed when you see all the things this church has done in the last year. You will be pretty impressed, honestly. Okay, I think we're ready for a closing song.
One more flower song. Let's do one verse because there were a lot of announcements. So great, we've got it up there. It's also in your books. Oh, are we? Oh, look, we're actually early. Okay, I didn't expect that. Okay, well, sure, let's do two verses. Let's live it up. Number 76. I feel like I'm really loud. Maybe you can turn me down a little bit. It's like I can't handle that much me. Number 76 in your books. I'll play through once since we're not short of time. Sure, why not? Three. Moments its light for rest and shelter of the night, for health and food, for love and friend, for everything thy goodness sends. Giver of all we thank.